Coming up on this week's newscast, we've got some special end-of-the-year announcements for you, including iPad return, commencement information, and special memories from the class of 2022. It's your last newscast of the school year, Bishop Knoll. Get ready, because BNN starts now. I'm Maria Emilia Quiroga. All iPads, cases, keyboards, chargers, and cables must be turned in upon completion of your last final exam. Once done with your final exam, drop off your iPad and accessories in the main lobby and sign off. If you do not turn in your iPad or its accessories and you are transferring from Bishop Knoll at the end of the school year, you will be charged for them. Seniors must also turn in their devices after their last final exam in order to have it removed from the Bishop Knoll server. Students who do not have any in-building final exams and will not be here exam week must drop off iPads on Friday, May 27th at the end of the day. Be sure to follow the instructions mailed to you in order to back up your files and reset your iPad. Only begin this process once you're totally done with your iPad for the semester, which will be most likely upon the completion of your very last final exam. If you do this too early, you may lose some important files. If your device or case is dirty or has evidence of food encrusted in it, clean it off. Use a slightly damp cloth, not a wet cloth, to gently remove any unwanted debris. A case or keyboard with food encrusted in it will result in a charge. You must have your iPad case, keyboard, cable, and charger with you on the day of your last final exam. Once you're done testing, bring everything down to the main lobby and sign off with Mr. Simkowski. Graduation will be on Friday, June 3rd at 6 in the Fieldhouse. If you are a non-senior planning to attend, you must receive a ticket. Next year, the Fine Arts Department will be offering some new advanced class in theater and art. Here's Vanessa Salazar with the story.
With the end of the year approaching, students should begin to consider their elective options for the new school year.
Recent additions have been added to the art and theater department, and we will get an inside look at what they consist of.
Is Kayla Conkle, or Mrs. K. I am the theater and speech teacher here at Bishop Knoll. We have Theater 1, which is a basic like introduction to acting, learning your stage directions, understanding how to use your body on stage, how to project your voice. We do a little bit of costume design, a little bit of set design. Theater 2, or theater history, is a more historical side of theater. After that, we have what's called theater production. So if you don't like acting and you don't want to be on stage, theater production is everything backstage. So, and then we have an advanced theater class, which is kind of honing in on our technical skills, learning very specific acting techniques, learning how to put together a play with playwriting. It's a more focused on building you as a performer.
I'm Ms. Guazda, and I teach a lot of the art classes here at Bishop Knoll. I teach ceramics, as well as intro to art, studio arts, and advanced 2D arts. Well, ceramics is primarily building three-dimensional works out of clay, and some of the projects we do in that class include a inch pot, we do a coil vase, we do a slab box, a plate, and where the students engrave on it. And then we culminate the class with something called the clay creature, where students incorporate all of the different techniques that they learn into one piece. Two-dimensional art classes, we explore painting and drawing with different forms of media. More advanced classes, we get options to do things like murals, like you can see the fabulous door behind me.
Here are the requirements for taking advanced theater and art classes.
For advanced theater, technically how it's supposed to work, you have to either take theater 1 and 2 or have been in a production.
To take the advanced 2D, you would have had to have intro 2D art, and then studio art you can take after you've had advanced. Ceramics is able for anyone to take.
Senior Adriana Alvarez explains her favorite part of theater and art classes, as well as who she would recommend them to.
My favorite part is being able to express yourself in different viewpoints of theater and art classes that you never thought of going in firsthand. I recommend these classes to anyone that's just looking to just expand their horizon on different kinds of art classes. Along with those who are a little more shy, this will help them like kind of branch out in school.
Out of the many fun projects completed in these classes, she expresses some of her favorites.
For theater, it has to be doing the monologues, especially ones that she has the students write. We just did a project for ethnotheater where we wrote monologues about our own lives, so that one was pretty cool. And then ceramics, it would definitely have to be the clay creatures. Those are the most fun to make.
And finally, the class of 2022 voted on their favorite memories, class lookalikes, and senior superlatives. Here are the results.
We'll be right back.
most likely, I had and recite. This is the newscast of the U. You made your choice and I have it. And then I'm so sorry. A little off one. Yeah, from Rolling Stone. Yeah, it was just from like last final. I'm reading too fast. Take your iPad back up on Diploma Pickup Day. No, it's just low power mode.